this section is performance and politics, the starting off with Jonah. And if we could keep question time quite concise, so please ask other questions, I'm not saying that people haven't been, so we can get to the evening performance and
where we'll all have time to discuss.
There will be time to discuss things. Okay, Jonah's going to
I was just going to say something quick. I talked about the Incontrabilia magazine earlier. I forgot that I brought a few copies out. It would be stupid of me to take them all back. So I'll leave a few here, just in case later someone is sort of, you know, wants to have a flip through, actually wants to take them back home. Yeah, so this presentation, Theatre Landscapes, is based on my dissertation research that I did between June and October this year at the West German Theatre Underwater, at Hertha Underwater. And in this, I really intend to explore the notion of theatre landscapes or theaterscapes, Theaterlandschaften, coined by its director, Roberto Trulli, and the dramatic advisor, Helmut Schäfer, who I'm going to refer to a couple of times in the actual presentation. And what theatre landscapes actually refers to is the vision that theatre is, on the one hand, always a local and contextual phenomenon, but at the same time, it's also about the establishment of connections between different local contexts, different landscapes, and they, you know, there are various, there are media scapes, food scapes, I mean, you have the various ethnographies I've done about scapes, theatre scapes could be one of them. And what it can do is it can not only bring different landscapes together, but it also bypasses some of the limitations of language or ethnicity or religious differences, in fact, by focusing on the fact that on stage, you interact in a very particular way, which doesn't necessarily depend on language by itself. So for the Theater an der Ruhr, the concept in fact is more than just a recognition of difference. It's brought to the attention of the German and in fact the international public, the theater landscapes of a whole nexus of regions, such as Yugoslavia, former Yugoslavia one should say, the Silk Road, North Africa, etc. And thereby initiated a certain dialogue, not just between the theatrical visions of these places, but different styles of lives, if you want to, different projects of artistic self-creation and social engagement. But in this presentation in particular, I want to argue that their vision of theatrescapes, in which they articulate the different texts and in their performances, is not only an expansion of the German hermeneutic philosopher Gadamer's notion of the fusion of horizons, Horizontverschmelzung, but in fact it's an anthropological quest in some sense for the appreciation of difference while recognizing the commonalities of humankind, not in an essentializing cognitive, but in a performative sense. And so doing so, I want to point out some of the enriching implications, in fact, of an anthropology of theater. For me, staging a play in another country means deciding to be there. Dreadful are ghosts who have never arrived in places. This is a quote from Roberto Trulli, the director of the theatre, and it's taken from a book, The Nine Conversations, that he's had with former actors, and that has been published, about the role of improvisation in theatre. And his work is sort of interspersed with photos of the man who is not in fact on here, but I think I have a photo of him later, of the Italian immigrant Roberto Trulli, is the co-founder of the theatre with his long grey hair, fully over his face, sitting there smoking a cigar. And you can kind of imagine the life as a migrant actor and director that he's had. Because before he founded the theatre in 1980, he left Italy after founding a theatre group, Il Globo, at the age of 26, and in fact completing a doctorate on Hegel. When he came to Germany, however, he began by working in factories, worked as a lorry driver, and then at some point, upon meeting these other dramatic advisors, he founded the Theater an der Ruhr in Western Germany. And Trulli's movements, in fact, I think constitute more than just an anecdote, because they give you a context of the notion of travel, which is important for the Theater an der Ruhr, as more than just a structure-building element, if you want to. Indeed, as Trulli put it to me personally, he said he understands theatre to have a universal language, one which provides the possibility to initiate a dialogue between cultures, societies, ways of life. For him, travel in that sense is both about a concept and about actual practice. It requires literal flexibility of a theatre company, improvisation in unforeseen consequences if you travel yourself, and an understanding for different contexts, people, and languages. In 1985, when Trulli and others coined this term, theatre landscapes, they meant to refer, as I said, to a number of related visions and aspirations about theatre, which they've translated into several projects that they've been doing over the years. So it's become sort of an annual occasion for international theatre to take place at the Tartan Avoir, in a housing in the park, in the garden, in the summer. But also for the ensemble itself to travel abroad, in fact. And from then on, Schaeffer, the dramatic advisor, recounted to me, the wish has been to try and understand other cultures, people, and perspectives by engaging with them, by meeting them, and that by, as I said, interacting with them in that sense. And I highlight the term since the aspiration was quite literally to get to know one another by acting together or hosting each other's troupes and performances. So over the years, the theater, for example, I mentioned, has, in 1986, they invited theaters from Yugoslavia, from Russia, the Silk Road, Iran, Palestine, Syria, accompanying theater performances, sort of debates about the socio-political situation in these countries. Therefore, sort of the obvious focus on regions in fact that that were hotspots. Yugoslavia, they invited in 1986. And with Iran and Iraq, they've been having sort of corporations for many years. Most recently, the Theater, and this is something quite specific to the Ruhr Valley as sort of a formerly industrialized area into which millions of guest workers were invited in the 1950s. They commenced a cooperation with independent theaters from Istanbul, in particular in Turkey. And it's truly expressed it to me, the project seeks to appreciate the enriching reciprocity which is possible between Turkish migrants in the Ruhr area and German actors, theatres, and audiences, which is something that, in fact, in that sense, hasn't really taken place. The term theatrescapes refers, therefore, to the possibility of movement in all physical as well as intellectual directions, of having to find an escape in order to live, as Kafka has his monkey, who then becomes a man, admitting a report to the Academy, which is played by Kurdish actor Ferhat Keskin at the theater. But the concept speaks of an alternative vision of society, which the theater seeks to constitute in some sense through interaction based on the art of acting. This perspective therefore recognizes society as something that is constantly escaping in some sense, and that is really made of lines of flight that can bypass what is usually seen as constraints. What the French philosopher Jules Deleuze perceives to be true for society is central therefore for the theatrescapes. They de- and re-territorialize perceptions, they reshuffle familiar assumptions, they move people, but more importantly, in fact, they make movements for actors, audiences, and thoughts possible in the first place. This was so, for example, when the Roma theater ensemble Pralipe, meaning something like Brotherhood, was housed semi-permanently, in fact, in the actual building where Roberto Trulli also himself lives. Following the Theatre Landscapes project with Yugoslavia. Travel then, according to Deleuze here, is a question of becoming, always incomplete, always in the midst of being formed, is a process that is a passage. And crucially, therefore, the theatre, and this is something, I'm not just inventing this, it's quite central to Trulli and the theatre itself, is the notion of travel. I'm going to jump over quite a number of things to come to this one here. I remember sitting in the ruby-coloured seats of the darkened main playroom, the sort of main, the only room that they had to act. And at the back of the stage stood a large blue wall, the one that you can see here, on top of which rested Volker Horst, the character on top there, reading the Frankfurter Allgemeine Rundschau, dressed in a silken gown, long blonde wig, playing the chain-smoking jester of Shakespeare's Twelfth Night and their interpretation of it. To the left, eight people sat on black stools and striped shirts with red buckles on their head, their hands hanging down next to their hips, until suddenly three of them stood up and regurgitated colored liquid onto the stage. And I wasn't quite sure in what sense I could bring that together with Shakespeare's Twelfth Night or the way that I, in fact, had understood the play. But this is exactly the point. The essayist Nabi Kermani, in fact, somebody who's written a lot about the theatre, has suggested, through sort of one of his recounting of an experience with Trulli, as he was as Kermani, this German essayist, in fact, was himself still a student, that what Shelley does with these plays, and in fact with the debates afterwards, which they encourage to with the audience, is to direct the gaze back at the audience to ask them what exactly their perceptions and their problems were. And this, to come to Gadamer, otherwise my reference at the start wouldn't have made sense if I could stop here. Gadamer says, Gadamer says that it's fundamentally important for the process of understanding that we open up such questions of understanding to multiple perspectives and empathy. I quote him, "If I put myself, say, in the position of another person, then I will understand him. That is, I will become aware of the otherness of that other person exactly because I put myself in his position." So for Gadamer, the process of understanding can therefore be re-described as a fusion of horizons, gaining horizons for his sense, and you know the spatial metaphor is one that theatre landscapes also takes up, means to look beyond the near and to see it in its larger possible context. His claim to a philosophical hermeneutics, which is, you know, Gadamer's quite different project, in fact, considers the understanding of languages, however, not merely as a process of interpretation, but as Wittgenstein put it, as an actualization of a life form. And the value of transcending a language-based approach, which is what Wittgenstein and Gadamer do, through theatre, is that you actually embody exactly these differences. You embody these different kinds of frictions in the material way that you either engage with your own body, in particular in Nunzi Sakone, sort of the Nazi sort of body cult that Leni Riefenstahl and others explore is worked upon. And so this particular kind of friction, or as Trulli said to me, the pain, the joy, the sorrow, the hope or mourning, no matter which affects or emotions, they are never bound to language. If we see a true actor, we realize that it is possible to communicate without really understanding the words we use to speak. So the theaterscapes, in that sense, is a project aimed at transcending exactly the limitations of merely regarding language as a meaning-making project. But I'll just leave it there. Yeah. Quick afterthought, because I didn't get to that. In fact, I sort of keep working on this at the moment because I don't like the idea of you know producing this as a finished thought at some point on this book. If anybody happens to be interested, yeah.
Thank you. You've got some really good pictures there as well. Yeah, if you want to go next, we've got.